Are you a health coach that thinks you have to look like a health coach or be in perfect health in order to help others? Are you actually maybe pushing clients away by trying to be perfect? In this video, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about how you might be sabotaging your own business by chasing perfection and how that can actually do the opposite when it comes to attracting the people you want to work with.
Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for new health coaching videos every Monday. And if you want to have a no-pressure chat about how we can help you reach your health coaching career goals, book a complimentary call with us here. IFHC, where we give you the blueprint for a successful, functional health coaching career that you're crazy about.
I'm Carmen Hunter. I'm the founder of the Institute for Functional Health Coaching and a successful health coach for almost a decade. And I've made just about every single mistake that health coaches are making today. And one of them is expecting yourself to look a specific way, present yourself a specific way, or to have overcome every health problem there is in order to help others. So what people are looking for today in a health coach is somebody that is going to be able to help them end the overwhelm. Help them to take action when they feel like they've done everything they can to get well and they're still stuck. They want someone that's going to be their cheerleader and their support system. Someone that's going to like hold them accountable for the changes that they're trying to make. They don't want somebody that looks perfect and is like, you can be just like me and this is how you get there. So what I would like to encourage you to do as a health coach, whether you're someone who is still dealing with a chronic condition or maybe a symptom that you can't seem to uncover or get to the bottom of, or maybe you're a health coach that is trying to shed the last 10 pounds and you think, until I do that, I can't teach people about weight loss. I want to encourage you to drop those ideas and those thoughts right out of your mind. And because what's going to happen here is it's going to open the door to all of the people that are looking for you right now. I've seen this happen over and over again. And I used to be a personal trainer. When I was personal training, I was in really good shape and I was really fit. But underneath that exterior, the way that I looked, I was dealing with digestive issues from the stress of trying to keep up with a schedule that wasn't working for me. I was not able to sit down at the kitchen table with my family the majority of the week because I was busy working when I shouldn't have been working. And it was all because I wanted to present myself as someone that was confident in what she was doing to help other people. I was passionate about getting my services out there so that other people could start to feel better. And in the meantime, underneath it all, I was trying to get control of a thyroid problem. I was trying to find out why my digestion was struggling. I was under more stress trying to reach a perfection state so other people would hire me than you could possibly imagine. So what I did was I decided to drop that and open up my story and share where I was and share where I'd been. And that just attracted more and more people to me. And I was told many, many times, oh my gosh, it's such a relief to hear that you have a thyroid problem, or it's such a relief to hear that, you know, you've been through these digestive problems, or that you've had adrenal issues before. It's a relief to them because what happens is they're trying to find a connection. And when people are trying to find a connection, they're looking for someone that understands where they've been and is able to support them to the goal that they're trying to achieve. So when we put on this perfectionistic outfit or this present ourselves as someone who has it all together all the time, and all we do is eat salads and drink green smoothies and we go to bed at 8 o'clock at night, that's really actually kind of overwhelming for people because they see us as unattainable. Like, I'll never be able to do that. I'll never be able to eat like you. I heard that so many times when I was in this the process of building my business. I heard, oh my gosh, you eat salad for breakfast and you drink bone broth for a snack. I'll never be able to do that. But what I ended up telling them was, listen, that's only at certain times. I still crave a gluten-free protein bar. I still want to make a batch of paleo muffins and eat more than two or three of them. You know, that really gives them just a sigh of relief. You can see it on their face when they know you're not perfect and you don't expect them to be either. And you know what they're going through. That means so much more than presenting ourselves, with no problems, at a perfect weight, eating and drinking perfectly all the time. So let's drop this perfectionistic idea of what we think people want to see of us, and let's present our authentic selves, the ones who really want to get to the bottom of the problems for people, even though we might be dealing with our own. And here's the other thing that's really cool, is when somebody finds a health coach that's in the process of working through their own issues, they know that you're still continuing to learn and you're investigating and you're in the process of getting even more information. And that's the person they want to learn from. That's the person they want to hire. Not someone who says, oh, I've been there, done that, and now I'm all good and we're going to get you there too. But you have to do all this hard stuff to be able to look like this. All right, so I'm hoping that this has brought some relief to you. Please post in the comments below if you've ever held back on helping people, or if you ever felt less than, if you ever felt like a fraud because you're not where you think you should be, or you don't look like you think you should just because you're a health coach. Post in the comments below. I'd love to read what you're doing. I'd love to read what you're thinking and feeling. And visit us at theinstituteforfunctionalhealthcoaching.com to find out more about building a successful health coaching practice.